Hello everyone and welcome to another Outriders video. Today I'm going to share with you the Devastator build that helped me unlock tier 15 expedition solo, focusing on the Vanquisher tree and firepower as our major attribute. So let's jump into it. For the gear pieces, after a lot of experiments and tries, we have two different approaches. The almost unlimited ammo bloody build and the crowd control build. In my opinion, the bloody build is a little better, it suits my playstyle a little more, since we will be doing a little less damage, but unconditionally, without worrying about ammo, so let's have a closer look at both builds so you can decide better for yourselves. For the bloody build, you will see all the gear pieces I used in the background, and 5 out of 5 armor pieces must definitely have bonus firepower and close range damage as their attributes. And for the first expeditions, until challenge here 10-11, around that, we don't mind using any third attribute, but for the endgame, challenge tier 12-13-14, we definitely need to find pieces with cooldown reduction that will help a lot with our rotation. The mods for the damage increase are Bloodlust, Personal Space, Crit Stack, Bloody Boost, and Plate Piercer. Our utility mods are the Vein Reaper and Vampiric Mag to not only ignore the reloading at most times, but also help us go through entire expeditions without the need to replenish our ammo. Although it may not be necessary in some occasions, I highly recommend to try it since it will save us a lot of time. For our survivability, we're going to use Damage Absorber, and you can either use one of the following. Choose to run the combination of Perseverance with Golem of Death. That will allow us to use the Golem skill and keep it up for at least 20 to 30 seconds in worst case scenarios, and for close to a whole minute in best case scenarios, making our survivability against hordes of enemies much easier. Or you can use Perseverance and Emergency Stance, since it will proc so often that will save our times in many occasions. A final suggestion, in case you still have some trouble surviving, try using all three defensive mods by sacrificing either the Plate Piercer or the Bloody Boost until you get used to the playstyle, and then you can switch your spec back. I personally highly recommend to have Emergency Stance since it saved me in many occasions. Now for our weapons, I tried a lot, and although I wish shotguns work a little better with lower gear. Until we unlock legendary pieces and some tier 3 mods, we're going to use Assault Rifle with the tactical variant that offers the highest burst damage that we need. The weapon attributes have to be at least armor pierce and close range damage. For the mods, we definitely need something for AoE since as a Vanquisher Devastator, we don't have many good options. Bone Shrapnel is one of the best for its high damage and synergy it offers with our armor mods. For the other second mod for your weapon, now here is where things get a little tricky. Until challenge tier 12, you can pretty much use some tier 2 options such as improve vulnerable bullets, death chains, anomaly surge, or even the ultimate ascent bullets we can get from Diago as a guaranteed legendary. But after that point, if you want to make your runs fast enough, you will have to get your hands on a decent tier 3 mod that will increase your DPS. That only applies if you wish to do gold timers for any expedition in challenge tier 14, otherwise there is one specific expedition we will talk about later that you can unlock without using any other tier 3 weapon mod other than the ultimate ascent bullets. I have some suggestions since thankfully as we level up we will be able to find some legendary weapons and we can also farm them using the wanted missions. You can use some AoE mods such as Singularity or Moaning Winds that will offer a huge increase in the so needed AoE damage, or others such as Embalmer's Rage for single target DPS increase. I believe that one of the best, if not the best tier 3 mod, and I personally suggest, is probably the Fortress that increases all our damage by up to 43%, but the only one I found after some grinding is the Killing Spree that offers a dramatic increase in our single target DPS. although the others can perform pretty close. For the secondary weapon, it's open to your preference, since most of the times we won't need to change our weapon thanks to the Bloody Vampiric combo, but you can have something with improved vulnerability bullets, or an LMG, double gun or SMG, just in case you run low on assault rifle ammo. For the sidearm, I never used it in all my expeditions, and for that reason I kept a rare quality one to level it up only using iron and help me increase my average item level faster. Our stats will look like this, having a little more than 100% extra close range damage and 60% armor pierce, which we benefit a lot. Unlike the other classes, we cannot ignore completely the enemy's armor, as we lack the special bullet skill, so the next best thing is to stack some armor piercing, as we can get 30% from our class plus another 30% from our weapon. We also have decent critical damage, thanks once again to our class and mods, and an always active 70% mitigation for physical damage because of the damage absorber, and it goes even higher in combat thanks to our talents that we will see below. For the class 3, we focus mainly on the Vanquisher and take most of the necessary assault rifle damage increase nodes apart from the assault adept. And do note that the 3 armor breakers are a must, as we have mentioned before. To further increase our damage and survivability, we're going to pick up Armor Ailurm and Stone Circle that will make a huge difference. Being able to get our close range damage bonus and also heal ourselves for every kill at a much better range. We also pick up Through the Mob for extra armor, and although this node will make a difference when facing a large number of enemies, I tried both this and the ammo stockpile just to have a little more consistency for the ammo refill bloody boost combination, and in the end I prefer the increased survivability for the end game content compared to the ammo consistency. Moving on to the skills, we are going to use Gravity Leap and Endless Mass as utility and a weapon damage increase to 70% thanks to the altered charge node that we can keep up for around 80-90% of the time, plus you also use the Golem skill in order to increase our survivability. For the second spec, you will see the pieces in the background along with the weapon of choice, and the changes I made are to have all 3 defensive mods on our armor without any of the 3 bleed utility ones. We also added the Ascent Boost and Ash Cleaner to our armor, and the ultimate Ascent Bullets to both our weapons to maximize our DPS. The only downside here is that we do not have the Bloody Vampiric combo, and although our reload speed is very fast when using either the Assault Rifle or SMG, we will eventually run out of bullets during expeditions, so you will need to be extra careful on your ammo count and try restocking only when needed to save as much time as you can. The advantages of this build is the high ground control thanks to the ultimate Ascent bullets, the high single target burst damage, and it's the easiest one to get. The only reason I changed this spec is that eventually I did not have any problem dealing with mobs, elites and bosses, however the ultimate Ascent bullets were enough to only take an elite close to 50% before gaining immunity to crowd control, and after that we were losing a lot of DPS. And let's have a closer look at a major upgrade you can do to the build by only adding one item, the legendary helmet Tanner's Hat, that will give you a huge firepower boost when facing enemies in close range. You can see in the background the difference before I use the Tanner's Hat, the damage is still high and you can still deal with enemies. But you can just replace the Perseverance mod and add the legendary armor piece to your build, and the DPS increase and time you will need to complete expeditions will skyrocket. With only this upgrade, I managed to do the Chem Plant Challenge Tier 14 in Gold Timer with only one try, which it wasn't the best one, where before, after multiple tries, trying to maximize the time. The best thing I could get was around 11 minutes and 20 seconds. Let's talk about some tips while using the build. Try saving some smaller mobs around you, and especially when you face alphas, elites and bosses. They will be able to heal you often with one or two shots and provide you a damage boost thanks to the bone shrapnel mod. Always try to prioritize and shoot the alphas while they try to buff themselves, in order to avoid getting nuked down, since you can take advantage of the corners and soft corners to avoid some of their jumps, while you keep firing at the enemies without aiming. Endless Mass is the perfect skill to trap enemies and gather them together for the full use and benefit of the Bone Shrapnel mod. And it works on most elites and even bosses, giving you a fast interrupt and also some needed time to survive. The same applies for Gravity Leap, as you can use it both defensively and offensively, jumping into the enemies, getting a damage boost, interrupting them, plus you can take your time before you slam into the ground if you get swarmed or cornered by enemies. You can also cancel the skill while being in air, although you will get a small internal cooldown, in that case for 1 or 2 seconds. Try to save the golem for either the parts that you know you will get swarmed, or use it a little more aggressively against bosses and elite enemies in combination with your damage increase skills to survive bursting them down before you die. And as always, try going for criticals while remaining in close range, unless you get swarmed. Finally, I would like to suggest to play and learn the Arcways of Inuk Expedition, since this is the easiest to do as a Devastator and unlock the tier 15 expeditions in solo. I managed to unlock the tier 15 expeditions with my first incomplete build, and in comparison after that I kept trying some other expeditions, but unfortunately none of them were as easy to compare and unlock the so wanted item level 50. I plan on making a separate video with a complete commentary for tips while you run this expedition solo in tier 14 with this build without any legendary pieces. And after I level up my gear, I will try and see how well this build works for challenge tier 15 solo and let you know the details. I really hope that this guide will help you with your Devastator expeditions and unlock that challenge tier 15 we all want. I would love to hear your comments and thoughts in the section below. Thank you all very much for watching. Subscribe for more upcoming videos for Outriders and other video games, and I wish you all a wonderful day.
Outrider, there's a storm coming your way.
There's a well.
Outrider detected. Access granted.